If you look at this and think about evolution of dental implants, you really, in order to appreciate that, you really have to understand the history of implants. And our history has been very important, and it's been very exciting to live this history because implant dentistry is so young. Most of us are in our careers have lived through this period, and so we've been able to understand and appreciate the changes that have occurred in implant dentistry over that time, and in fact be a part of that. So that's extremely exciting to understand. So let's talk about evolution of dental implants just for a few minutes. First of all, as has been pointed out this morning already, Dr. Eckert did that very nicely, that when implants were used that were blade-type implants, you would put those in someone's mouth, and then when you went to bed at night, you didn't know whether that was going to be successful or not. It was like a flip of a coin. It was 50-50. So that was not very exciting to be a part of placing blade implants because we didn't know what the predictability was going to be. Of course, Dr. Brandemark was the one who made that very seminal observation that if we didn't overheat the bone and we didn't overload the bone, then we could get an integration of a biocompatible material. In this case, he was using titanium. And that clearly was what changed the world for all of us and why we're here today. What Brandemark did after that was advance that observation that he made with little titanium chambers, that he looked at blood flow, and that's how he made that initial observation using these titanium chambers, looking at blood flow underneath the chambers. But he advanced that observation to replace teeth in edentulous mandibles with a very specific clinical protocol.